you're gonna take a couple of stems, and then from the stems, you're gonna take the leaves only. You separate them. You don't need a lot. You start normally small, because the idea is that afterwards you're gonna put the sugar with the mint, but you're not gonna just put the mint leaves in the sugar. You're gonna a bit like crush them with a rolling pin. Now, I personally like to use a cutting board, and then I have on the cutting board I put one piece of baking paper or parchment paper, then I add my mint leaves. I don't have much. I use the remaining sugar from my open white sugar. Not much. And then make sure that it is centered. As you can see, now I have more sugar than mint, so I'm gonna add a few more leaves of mint. The Moroccan mint, as I mentioned earlier, has a nice flavor, but also a scent. It's also the mint that's used for Moroccan mint tea, and also here, at least in at home, for example, when my mom ever gets a cocktail, or for example, especially like a cocktail which requires mint, like mojito, we use the Moroccan mint. So then I put a second parchment paper on top of the sugar and mint, and I take my rolling pin. The rolling pin you're gonna put at the center, and you're gonna start rolling. Don't worry about the sound. The sound that you hear is the sugar being crushed with the mint. Parchment paper. You can also use cling film, but personally I use parchment paper. The idea is you continue this process until your sugar turns green. As green as the same green as your mint. So it's gonna take a few steps. But yeah, you continue until the sugar is green. And already with the crushing process of the mint, you already smell the mint coming out. So as you can see, slowly the sugar is becoming green. You continue this process until it's fully green. The mint sugar, you can keep it for a couple of days because of the end, it will stay green for those days. But not too long, so use it as quickly as you can. And the third one. Area.